Hello everyone, welcome to An Analysis of Dance, where we discuss the movements and debuts of the Billboard Hot Dance Charts in immaculate detail, with in-depth reviews of each debut each week. I was both surprised and not surprised with this week. On one hand, it felt expectedly busy with a ton of new arrivals. It's just that so few of them came from Diplo or Bob Moses this week, the latter not netting any new songs off the silence in between. I mean, I should have guessed that both weren't exactly huge enough to trigger a massive impact. The streaming just hasn't caught on with either to the extent I expected, but it still is disappointing given that both are excellent albums that would have boosted the quality of the charts otherwise. Especially when on the surface the other debuts look like a total goddamn mess. Anyways, our top 10, where Cold Heart P&A remix by Elton John and Dua Lipa reigns on top yet again, leading in sales and streaming with airplay still holding this up. You've all heard this before, it's not going anywhere. Peppers by Faruko has the exact same deal at number 2, with streaming holding and sales actually recovering this week. It's gonna be stagnant here until some real challenge comes up. And honestly, at this point, I really hope it comes. That being said, the motto by Tiesto and Ava Max at number 3 can possibly overtake it with time, as streaming and sales continue to hold, with radio really gaining on this in a big way. It may have slowed down somewhat in the Hot 100, but I can see it making a push should those formats remain steady as Peppers falls. What isn't going to get a push at this point is Do It To It by A-Craze featuring Cherish at number 4, which is bleeding hard on radio even if the sales and streaming are pretty decent. This is on the way out, no worries, it had a good run. That also ties into what the hell will happen with When I'm Gone by Alesso and Katy Perry at number 5, which just doesn't have the streaming or airplay to even challenge at this point, even if sales did rebound. It's right on the borderline of being kicked off the Hot 100, which means it will probably start to stall out and fall a fair bit. What's interesting here comes with Where Are You Now by Lost Frequencies and Callum Scott at number 6, and honestly, once radio and sales are able to match the solid streaming, I can see this possibly making a run for the bubbling under. I mean, we gotta hope, right? The song is great. This brings us to El Incomprendido by Farruko, Victor Cardenas, and DJ Donny at number 7, relying mainly on Latin radio and streaming while the sales just aren't there. This is definitely vulnerable, should literally anything else with traction come along. And honestly, I can't complain about that either. It's been sitting around for way too long in the spot. Speaking of which, this takes us to Dancing Feet by Kygo featuring DNCE, falling off the debut to number 8. Look, it has radio, but when streaming and sales both absolutely nosedive this week, it wasn't gonna stick around where it was. Very telling that the only format it survived was the one not influenced by the general public. Just saying. Anyways, that leaves our 2 remaining songs which remain stagnant from last week. Moth to a Flame by Swedish House Mafia on the weekend at number 9, losing in all categories besides streaming where it did rebound. And most surprisingly, Don't Forget My Love by Diplo and Miguel only remaining stagnant at number 10. I guess folks weren't as enthusiastic to give this the attention the newer tracks on the album got, as streaming just didn't really go anywhere this week. But the sales did rebound, and it does have minor airplay to benefit, so I guess it could stick long term? Maybe? What isn't sticking long term are our falls and fall-offs this week. In the latter category, we had some unfortunate misses for the year-end list, like You've Got to Let Go If You Want to Be Free by Disclosure and Zed, Pieces by Avion, Vice and Leone, Why Did That Underperform, and on a slightly better note, the fortunate underperformance of In Your Arms for an Angel by Topic, Robin Scholz, Nico Santos, and Paul Van Dyke. But the real notable case is Undeniable by Kygo featuring ex-ambassadors dropping out after hitting 20 weeks. It's made the year-end list, it's probably the best of Kygo's recent singles, and I definitely can't complain that it's gone. Our losers, meanwhile, my god, there were so many of them this week. I mean, let's get our continued losers out of the way first, with Say Nothing by Flume featuring Maya at 38, Shinigami Eyes by Grimes at 39, Original Sin by Sofi Tukker at 42, I expected that would do better, Jealousy by FKA Twigs featuring Rammer at 43, Hallucination by DJ Regarding Years and Years at 44, and most notably, Headlights by Alan Walker and Alok featuring Kiddo remaining one of their biggest flop singles at 48. This could very easily drop out the next week. My god, this was a flop. Our debuts also saw some massive knocks with Red Light by Swedish House Mafia and Sting only falling to 29, interesting, as well as Run by Becky Hill and Glances down to 25. Outside of that, Human by John Summer featuring Echoes took a sudden hit to 37, as did I Wish by Joel Corey and Mabel at 34, and Broken in All the Right Places by Lost Kings featuring Modsun at 33. But the most notable hit came with Follow Me by Sam Fell featuring Rita Ora down hard to 27 as airplay slows down. Honestly, the song really overperformed outperformed all expectations for Modern Sam Feld, and it's probably his best song to date, so I'm absolutely not complaining that it's exiting naturally. It had a really good run and will comfortably make the year-end list for 2022. Of course, in a week this busy, our jumps and comebacks this week was ridiculously small. We had zero comebacks this week first off, which did kind of surprise me given you think Promises would come back, but whatever. And the songs that did jump were all incredibly easy to predict, but also extremely promising moving forward for 2022. Love Brand New by Bob Moses rides the album boost into the top 20 at 18. Better Now by Odessa featuring Marrow gains that full week of traction at 19. And Everything But You by Clean Bandit featuring A7S thankfully rebounds huge to 32. It seems to be a thing with Clean Bandit where the songs gain a big boost on their third week. And given how much I really like the song, I'm glad it could possibly stick around and become a hit. Let's make it happen. But moving on from that, we have a pretty large list of new roles with varying levels of excitement and surprise from me. Starting off with... And if I ever go missing, then the world would keep spinning, cause I'm just an entertainer, so... A song off of Krewella's new album to chart kind of surprises me, not gonna lie. I mean, I get this duo still has residual popularity given how much they popped off in the early 2010s, but given the extremely muted response and mixed reviews to their newest album, I didn't think any song from it would chart, let alone a deep cut that wasn't even released as a single. So okay, here's a song and... man, I wish this was better. I mean, it definitely shows some promise early on with those verses that have a similar vibe to the meltdown that's gotten popular from artists like Seven Lions and Tribecta, with those gorgeous synths and the sisters' vocals sounding really well together. But then there's the drops. And look, I get the appeal of Jersey Club, I'll say it, but these drops feel really out of place and sound pretty rough, especially with that flutely placed near the front of the mix that sounds quite pitchy and annoying. It sucks too, because the melody is nice and the diversion into trap on the second drop was really, really solid. But the Jersey Club elements just really take me out of the song, I'm sorry. Not a bad song at all, I can definitely enjoy this, but the contrast doesn't entirely work for me. I can see it growing on me though, so yeah, it's okay, I guess. But I am here. Let me help. Okay, maybe not. I'll just let you yell at me all you want. Okay, so since I mostly like Original Sin, I was curious where Sofi Tukker would go for their next single, recruiting a little-known Turkish DJ with a history of deep, world-inspired house, and wow, this is great. You can definitely hear where Mahmut Orhan partook in the production, especially with those gorgeous violins and the heavier horns that become way more emphasized for those absolutely stunning drops. It's a sort of song that feels almost cinematic in its approach, and certainly not the type of thing I expected to hear from a Sofi Tukker song. Sophie's vocals should also be noted here. She sells the hell out of this song with some really terrific high notes and the right emotionality that match the lyrics about confronting someone's general distaste and desire to hurt after a breakup. It's quite raw, very well produced. I like this a lot. It's a shame it probably won't be a hit, but hey, it's nice to see you nonetheless. Great song, check this out. More money that I make, the less that I trust these hoes. Just cause you're coming around, think you can call me bro. We start dumbing it down, we start dumbing it down. Don't get humble now. Okay, so since I've already covered the Diplo self-titled album in full, the reviews here are mostly going to be pretty short for the sake of not repeating myself. This one I was initially worried about when I saw the track listing, but my god, I was really surprised how much I love this one. The production has such a groovy bounce that reminds me a lot of Charmy, especially in the percussion, which is really heavy but incredibly fun and rather smooth progression-wise. Speaking of which, I get a lot of similarities to Praise with this song, especially given Lil Yachty sticks more in his lower rap delivery, which flows way too well over this beat. I honestly wish he appeared in more songs like this. He's really good at it. So yeah, it's not a particularly deep or smart song, but it doesn't need to be. It's just an absolute banger from start to finish. Easily one of my favorites on the album. Check this out. Actively dreading this one would be an understatement. Alan Walker's recent batch of singles have been mediocre at best, and coming off of one of his worst songs in recent memory with Headlights, I was worried about this... So, colour me surprised that I actually might think this is his best thing that he's made since All Falls Down. Or at least close to it. Yeah, seriously, I actually really like this one a lot. The production calls back to his 2016 days with the punchy synths, the smoother percussion, and drops that lean more towards the tropical side of house and sound really damn nice. Credit must also be given to Torine, who delivers Alan Walker one of the best vocal performances on any song he's made. She really sells the lyrics expressing excitement and returning to normality after all the world has gone through. Yes, I will admit this side of Alan Walker has been done better before, but given how many of his genre excursions recently have just been total duds, to see him going back to his roots and creating a really nice breezy house cut, it's at least a flavour he can nail well even to this day. So, yeah, I don't expect this to have any staying power, but I actually really dug this more than I ever would have expected. Great song, I can recommend this. And even that feels weird to say, not gonna lie. Honestly, out of all the debuts from Diplo, this is the one I have the least to say about. Yes, it's definitely one of the more interesting cuts on the album, mainly due to diverging slightly from the progressive house sounds that the rest of the album explores. And I will admit that Leon Bridges sounds really good on this beat. He has this warmth to his vocals that makes songs this relaxed really click for me. But I will admit the production isn't as immediately gripping as other tracks that came later on the album. I definitely like the vibe this one creates, but it does feel a bit repetitive and the change in percussion doesn't always make it a track that I would return to more than most on the album. Very good song, but there are better on the album. I will say, I'll definitely take it over. Bounce that shit, make it go. Trampoline, bounce that shit to the flow. Trampoline, bounce that shit, make it go. Trampoline, bounce that shit to the flow. Trampoline. Are we seriously doing this again? Truth be told, I haven't enjoyed any song that Guetta's done with a rapper since Memories with Kid Cudi 13 years ago. They feel so cheap, try hard, and incredibly obnoxious every single time. Especially when it's clear the rappers involved would rather be doing anything else instead of rapping over a cheaply made, lowest common denominator beat, with barely any emotion put into it whatsoever. So not only to see Guetta doing this, but also working with Afrojack and three rappers who should really know better, rock bottom expectations as a result, and wow, this sucks. I mean, let's get the obvious four out of the way first. The production is complete crap. The ascending synths get incredibly annoying. The vocal production on Missy Elliott's hook is terrible. The bass overpowers the song and really makes it sound cheap as all hell. The track barely changes from the verses to the hook. I just don't understand how two producers with 10 plus years in the industry are still struggling to make their mixes sound good. Especially in Afrojack's case, where even his recent releases sound more competently mixed than this. But then we have our rappers. And it may be a bad sign that Doechii has the best verse here. She's at least a better rapper than Beer, who sounds completely tuned out and anonymous, and Missy Elliott, who delivers one of the most laughably embarrassing hooks I've heard all year. And even then, her lyrics are just cringe. I need the pot the way I'd be shitting. Bounce that ass in tropical, is that ass a fraud or no? And that's not even touching on her constant dropping of rhymes or rhyming or no with itself, or how she tries so hard to be quirky in a similar vein to Doja Cat and doesn't hold a candle to her personality or wit as a rapper. Yeah, this is atrocious, which given the history of these two doesn't surprise me at all. Absolute crap. Let's not make this a hit at all because it's terrible. Pass. And on the topic of songs I was dreading listening to, okay, seriously, do we really need to still give Subtronics charting songs? Fractals was a terrible album and Gassed Up only cemented that. So to see Subtronics working with REZZ was just downright painful for me. Especially given how REZZ has shown some steady growth as a producer since the release of Spirals. She's kind of growing on me as of late, not gonna lie. So yeah, another song with rock bottom expectations. And once again, colour me surprised by this. It's so odd too, this is a song that really doesn't diverge too far from what REZZ or Subtronics have done before. Especially with the darker production, building out of a really creepy mix that ramps up for those drops. but the choice to go for a neurofunk adjacent sound really does work in this case. The drops have some energy, the leads are surprisingly not that annoying, which is a plus for Subtronics, and it has a solid build-up with a potent atmosphere. The song isn't trying to be insanely heavy, but rather just allow the darkness to slowly and subtly build as the track goes on. Not much more to add. I do wish the drops had a little bit more going on. They can sound a bit too dry at times, but otherwise I was really digging this way more than I ever expected. I don't think it's gonna last very long, but for what it is, I actually found myself liking this way more than I should. Good track. I'm surprised by that. I'm not remotely surprised that the song was the highest debut from the album's release. It's got Kareen, Lomax on it, was released as a single after the album dropped, got a proper video, and it also happens to be a really great song in its own rights. Kareen, Lomax delivers a fantastic vocal performance as per usual. The mix is quite large and atmospheric, almost giving off a Love Regenerator vibe, which is definitely a plus, as those pianos and the breakbeat percussion build to a great hook that pays off the verses really well. It's absolutely a song I can see going off in a club environment, which given how the world is slowly opening up, I mean, I don't expect it to have as much staying power as Looking For Me even Promises did, but for the time it's here, I'm really digging this. It's not one of my favorites on a stacked album, but it's still pretty great. Check this out. So yeah, that honestly ends a week that, while definitely different from what I expected, turned out fantastic and absolutely shocked me with how much of the debuts managed to hold their own. I mean, obviously discounting Trampoline by David Guetta, Afrojack, Bia, Missy, Elliott, and Doechii, just a complete dumpster fire of a song that I hope flops hard. It's easily the worst of the week. That being said, I can't really keep out a dishonorable runner-up. That Krewella song had enough good elements to save it from that spot, and I can honestly see it growing on me once I get past the jarringness of those drops. So in that spirit, I'm giving out a tie for best of the week between Humble by Diplo and Lil Yachty and Forgive Me by Sofi Tukker and Mahmut Orhan. Both really surprising debuts that blew me away. But that also means for runner-up, we have Let You Go by Diplo and TSHA featuring Kareen Lomax, actually tying with Hello World by Alan Walker and Torine. Yeah, I'm serious. That song really surprised me in a good way. Next week, the fallout from this mess, and given I unfortunately don't see a lot of these debuts sticking around, it could be very interesting what will happen moving forward. But yeah, that's all for this episode of An Analysis of Dance. See you next time.